हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड स्कूल। आई एम पूजा राजमाने। आई एम योर कंप्यूटर टीचर। हार्डवेयर मीन्स द फिजिकल पार्ट ऑफ कंप्यूटर आर कॉल्ड हार्डवेयर एंड सॉफ्टवेयर इंस्ट्रक्ट द कंप्यूटर इंस्ट्रक्ट द हार्डवेयर हाउ टू वर्क। वी स्टडीड अप टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स। वी विल सी दिस। वी स्टडीड but we will see what is the first number. Hardware refers to that part of computer which you can touch or feel. Software is the program that tells the hardware how to work. MS Paint is an example of application software. Next, system unit is also known as central processing unit. Motherboard is like a mother of the other circuit board. RAM stand for random access memory. ROM stand for read only memory. The hard disk stores data permanently. A modem is a device that links the computer to the internet. A sound card can be slotted into a computer to allow the use of audio. We studied in this last period only. Now we will see our next question number 6. Fill in the missing letter. We have to fill this letter, missing letter, and we have to do the meaningful word. What is the first number? S. What will come here? Which spelling it is? S O. It is the spelling of software. What is the spelling of software then? S-O-F-T-W-A-R-E. Software. S-O-F-T-W-A-R-E. The spelling of software. Next one. H-A. Then. What is the spelling it is? Hardware. H-A-R-D-W-A-R-E. Hardware. H-A-R-D-W-A-R-E. Hardware. Next one is a monitor. M-O-N-I-T-O-R. What is the spelling of monitor? M-O-N-I-T-O-R. Next, this is the part of computer. What is the spelling of this part? P-R-I-N-T-E-R. Printer. P-R-I-N-T-E-R. Printer. Now, this one is a S-O. What spelling will come here? S-O-U-N-D-C-A-R-D. Sound card. S-O-U-N-D-C-A-R-D. Sound card. Next one is a RAndom, random, ACCESSS, and MEMORY, memory, random access memory. Next, what will come here? What will come? Read only memory. What is the spelling of read? R-E-R-E-A-D. Read. O-N-L-Y. Only. And memory. M-E-M-O-R-Y. Memory. Read only memory. Next one is a this one, M-O-D-E-M, modem, M-O-D-E-M, modem. This one is a word pad, W-O-R-D, word, P-A-D, pad, word pad, W-O-R-D, P-A-D, word pad. Next, last one is a M O T H E R mother, then B O A R D. Understand? Missing letters, motherboard. First one is a software, hardware, monitor, printer, sound card, random access memory, read only memory, then modem, word pad, and last one is motherboard. Understand everyone? You must have to complete your skill sheet. Now next one, match the following. We have to compare with their work, what they are doing for us, means what is the working of this given word, we have to find out. First one is a paint. What is the working of paint? What is the use of paint? A device that links the computer to the internet, allows the computer to produce sound, used for typing letters and content, used for drawing and paint. What is the use of paint? Used for drawing and paint. What is the number of this working? It is fourth one. Answer, don't draw the lines. Answer is downside. Here is a 1, A. Then already given A, and what is the answer of A? Used for drawing and paint. It is fourth number. Then we have to write here fourth. Then word pad. What is the use of word pad? Why we are using the word pad? Yes, word pad used for typing letters and content. What is the number of this? Third. B already given. Then in front of B we have to write 3. Okay. Now MSW logo. MSW logo. What is the use of MSW logo? This one finish, this one finish. The device link the computer to the internet, allows the computer to produce sound, used for drawing through a code and language. What is the use of MSW logo? Used for drawing through the coding language. What is the number here? 5. In front of C, we have to write 5. Now, D1, MS PowerPoint. What is the use of PowerPoint? A device that links computer to internet, allows a computer to produce a sound. Next, used for typing letters and content, used for drawing and paint, used for drawing through coded language, used to make a presentation. What is the use of MS PowerPoint? Used to make a presentation. What is the number here? 6. Then in front of D, we have to write 6. Next, RAM, RAM. What is the long form of RAM? Random access memory, RAM. What is the number? 8. Next, ROM, ROM. What is the number? What is the long form of ROM? Read only memory, ROM. What is the number of ROM? Read only memory, it is 7 number. Then we have to write here 7. Now, G1, sound card. What is the use of sound card? What is the use of sound card? Allows the computer to produce sound. It is 2nd number. Now, last one, H1, modem. What is the use of modem? A device that links the computer to the internet. It is 1st one. Understand? Uses. Now, next number question. Explain briefly RAM and ROM. Firstly, we will see about RAM. What is mean by RAM? RAM stand for random access memory. RAM stand for random access memory. It is known as primary memory of computer. RAM is known as primary memory of computer. RAM chips store data temporary. RAM chip store data temporary. It erases all data once the computer is switched off. If we switch off computer, then RAM erases all the data. Then we will see about ROM. ROM stand for read only memory. ROM stores the instruction which are used to operate a computer program. ROM stores the instruction which are used to operate a computer. ROM is like reading a library book. Means we can read only, we cannot change in that. Same like a library book. It does not erase data once the computer is switched off. Who erases the data? RAM erases the data. But ROM does not erase the data. RAM is temporary and it is primary memory. And RAM stands for random access memory. ROM stands for read only memory. It stores the instructions which are used to operate a computer program. And it is like a reading book from a library, and it does not erase the data once the computer is switched off. Now, next nine number, distinguish between hardware and software. What is mean by hardware and what is mean by software, and explain with the example. Difference between hardware and software, we have to explain with the help of example. What is mean by hardware? Hardware is a physical part of computer. Hardware is physical part, means touchable part. And software means what? Software is a program that tells the hardware how to work. Software is a program that tells the hardware how to work. Next, about the hardware. It refers to that part of computer which you can touch or feel. Means hardware we can touch or feel. And what is mean by software? It is set of command or code or coded instruction that we give to the computer in the form of program. Means software means what? It is the set of command or coded instruction that we give to the computer in the form of program. What is the example of hardware? CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse, means touchable part are called as a hardware. And software means it is present in a computer and we cannot touch. MS Word, Notepad, WordPad, that are useful, we can use it, but we cannot touch or feel. Understand difference between hardware and software. Now, next and last, write the correct word for the following. We have to write only single word for the following. Another name of system unit. What is the another name of system unit? Anyone can tell? Yes. Another name of system unit is CPU. Next, a program that tells the hardware how to work. Who tells hardware how to work? Yes, good. It is software. Software tells the program how to work. A device that links the computer to the internet. Third one, a device that links the computer to the internet. Who? Modem. M-O-D-E-M. Modem link the computer to the internet. D1, mother of the circuit board. Mother of the circuit board. Who is the mother of circuit board? Yes, mother board. M-O-T-H-E-R-B-O-A-R-D. Mother board. Next, physical part of computer. Physical part of computer means touchable part of computer. What we call? Hardware. H-A-R-D. WARE, hardware. Next, main source of cooling of a computer. Main source of cooling of the computer. Who cool the computer? Good. Computer fan. ComputerFan. Computer fan is the main source of cooling of the computer. Next, store data permanently. Who store data permanently? Hard disk. HARDDISK. Hard disk store data permanently. And store data, last one is store data temporarily. Who store data temporarily? RAM. 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 RAM store data temporary. Okay. Yes, by mistakely, it is all letters must be capital. RAM. All letters must be capital. RAM. Understand? Now we will see how to write on Microsoft Office Word. How to write in Microsoft Office Word. Okay. If I want to write in Notepad, WordPad, then for writing which part we are using? Keyboard. Keyboard is useful for writing letters, numbers. Okay. Now we will see if I want to write. I am student. Now which key I use for writing? Yes, alphabet key. Alphabet key I use for writing. Now I want to this letter big, then how? Firstly, I have to select it. Afterwards, here are size. You can see the changes, right? I want this size, then this size. And here is also we can, what happened? The font is big. Now I want small, then this. Okay, this for growing font, this for small font. Now if I want to change the color, what is the color here now? Black color. But I want to change the color, then here is the A font color. If we want to change a font color, you can see the changes. Yes. Now I want this color, then I will take this color. This background color is white, but I want change this color also. Then this, by using here we can change background color also. Okay. But for every changes, if we want to change anything, firstly we have to select it. If I not select and if I increase the size, then it is increasing, it will not increase. First, for any changes we have to select it. I want now these are the alignment. This which alignment now? Left alignment. Then it is center alignment, it is right alignment, and it is justify. Now I want to change the alignment, means position of this sentence. If I want to change, if I want to change in middle, then it is in a center. If I press here, then it will go which side? Left side. It will go right side. Now I want this justify. You see the changes. Now if I do the justify alignment, then you see the changes. If it is paragraph, then it will come in a like that. Okay, starting and ending in one line only. Now if I want to go next line, Now my cursor is here and I want to go to the next line. Then how will I go? Yes, by using enter key. By using enter key, I will go to the next line. My cursor is here. Small blinking line is called as a cursor. Now, if I wanted to write I study in class 3. I study in class 3. Okay. If I want to give space, you can see the space. Here space is there. This is one word. Here space is there? No. It is one word. Then if I want to give the space, if I want to give the space, then which key I will use? I will use space bar key. Longest key from the keyboard, space bar. And now I wrote here number 3, right? For writing this 3 number, which key I use? Numbers key. Numbers key are two side. Here's also number key and here's also number key. If I wanted to write numbers, then I use number key for writing numbers. If I wanted to erase, my cursor is here and I want to erase this S, then which key is useful? Backspace key. You can see the changes. S is also deleted and double S is also deleted and A is also deleted. And I want to write, I will write here. Understand? Now, I want the numbers. Sorry, I want the symbols. Then these are the bullets. Bullet library, these are symbol we can take. First number, then if I want this symbol, then 1. Automatically it will come downside also when we press the enter. I want the symbol like that, then I will use these bullets. But now if I want numbers, then from where I will take these numbers? From this second number. I want two symbols, then I will use first number. Okay, this one, first one. These are bullets, different types of bullets. Now, if I want to numbers or alphabet means A, B, C, D or Roman numbers, then I can take it. You can see the changes. Okay. And if I wanted to save it, if I want save it, then how to save? Firstly, it is which button? It is office button. When we press the office button, then this type of option will become new. We want new file? No, we don't want new file. When we click this button is called as a office button. When we click this button, then this type of menu will become. First is a new. If we want to take a new file, then we will use this new. If you want to open already exit file, then we use this open. But now we have to save, then we will do save. When we click the save, then this type of window will become. Where we have to save, it depends on us. We will save on desktop and we will give name. I will give we can give any name. I will give here XYZ and then save. See, this name will become upper side. It is called as a title bar. XYZ. What name I will give to file, it will come upper side. Okay, it is called as a file. It is file. Here our file will be. Now I want to make a folder. Then how to make a new folder? I am on desktop. Then press the button. Then here new option is there and folder. New folder. Suppose my roll number is 3. Then I will give here 3. Okay. It is folder and XYZ is file, and we can keep this file in folder. When you are coming to school, then you are coming with your bag, right? Bag having different notebooks. You can store in one bag different notebooks. These notebooks and books are like our file, and bag is our folder. Understand? We can keep more than one file in single folder. Understand? Now practice this. Don't use much more mobile, but for understanding alphabet keys and number keys, you can use the mobile. By using mobile phone, you must understand the use of alphabet keys and number keys. What we studied in our lesson number 3, what is mean by hardware and what is mean by software. We will see our next chapter in next session. Thank you.